केंद्र सरकार में सचिव डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह जी, श्री राधाकृष्णा माथुर जी, श्रीमती मंजुला प्रसार जी और DOPT का सचिव श्री अजय मित्तल जी आज यहाँ विज्ञान भवन में इस समारोह में आए हुए सभी अधिकारीगण और इन्फॉर्मेशन कमिश्नर्स और देश भर से आए हुए प्रतिनिधि बंधुओं, ये ओकेशन इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड आई वॉज वंडरिंग व्हेन श्री जितेंद्र सिंह वॉज मेंशनिंग अबाउट his inability to come and then his ability to come because of the God has been kind or unkind to him, I don't know. Finally he could make it. I was wondering, fortunately now I am not in politics, otherwise I would have faced a similar situation also. Because I am now reminded of the situation in India. There is always an election festival. Every 6 months there will be some election. Election means 3-point program: selection, collection and election. Selection of the candidates, that will take time. Then collection of donation, because no party can fund itself, and then election. The process goes on for 3 months, 4 months, then within next 2-3 months another election. That's why the country political leadership and all political parties should seriously think over the need to have simultaneous elections, so that your attention can be focused on the responsibility that is given to you. I am talking right from the top to the below. At various level there is a diversion because of elections. I remember when I was young, before 67 and all elections used to be over, from parliament to panchayat and to cooperatives also, within a particular period. But now the season, like seasons, winter season, summer season, we are having elections. This is not the creation of this party or that party. I am just sharing my thoughts and also the feelings of the countrymen, that there should be one fixed tenure. Second is that you have to conduct elections without any exception within a particular time, including, I must say, even panchayats also, which are a casualty nowadays, you postpone the election in some pretext or other. Friends, the Information Commissioner's annual Day or annual convention, I am happy to be here today with all of you on the occasion of the 12th annual convention of the Central Information Commission, marking the 12th anniversary of the enactment of the Right to Information Act. Sharing the information and creation of a transparent governance structure accountable to the people of our country are key pillars of our democracy. If what Mr. Jitendra Singh was telling in the last about 4 points, if these are fulfilled, then there is no need for a commission. We are creating new infrastructure, adding commissions, adding tribunals, adding regulatory bodies, because in system we are not able to run it effectively as per the spirit of the acts which we are passing. Keeping that in mind, people at the helm of affairs, particularly the politicians and also the bureaucrats, they must focus their attention on two important things according to me. I also have some administrative experience as the minister for some time in the government and also a parliamentarian for more than a legislator, more than 30 years. That transparency, accountability, these are two important key elements for the success of democracy. Humko swarajya mila hai, swarajya ko suraj ke roop mein badalna, ye hamara samne jo mukhya agenda hai. अपना पार्टी, हर एक पार्टी का अपना अपना मैनिफेस्टो होता है, अपना कार्य प्रणालिका होता है उसके आधार पर लोग सोचते हैं ना सोचते मुझे मालूम नहीं, फिर भी एक बार सुनने के बाद हमको ऐसे स्वीकार करना पड़ेगा, दिस इज इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द मैंडेट गिवन बाय द पीपल, दैट देर इज एन अप्रूवल ऑफ दिस मैंडेट, दिस एजेंडा ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट एटसेट्रा. बट द एंड ऑफ द डे डिलीवरी सिस्टम दैट हैज बिकम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. And we must also create a feeling in the minds of the people that I also have a stake in this government, in this system. And the fruits of development should reach everyone. That's why the government has given a slogan, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. And this is in tune with our philosophy, of ancient philosophy. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu, Vasudhaika Kutumbam. These are the basic philosophies of our country and our civilization. So that's why I always feel information can be empowering if it is authentic. And I coined a phrase, information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. Because there are a lot of information available, whether information is correct or not, you don't know. There are a lot of media, social media also is there, and then electronic media is there, you have too many channels, more than 1,000 channels. They have breaking news, making news, good news, bad news. नहीं तो खुद उनका news भी चलाते हैं कभी कभी. आज तक कल तक सीधी बात उल्टी बात कितना बात है याद रखना भी मुश्किल हो रहा है आजकल. So what is important is information with confirmation. That's where the information commissioners, information whatever you give, whatever order you pass, that deems to be confirmation. So that's why you have a great onerous responsibility on you. Lack of information can lead to rumor mongering or disinformation campaigns, and also it also leads to exploitation, to corruption. Then the enactment of the Right to Information Act in 2005 and even before that, passing of Freedom of Information Act in the 2002 was a watershed in the democratic march of our country. Indeed, the adoption of the citizen's right to information has enabled each citizen to be better informed and more actively participate in the governance of the country. This enhanced access to credible information makes our democracy more progressive, participatory, and meaningful. The citizens now have confirmation that the information is authentic. This can be potential ammunition to fight injustice and crimson the polity. According to Kautilya, good governance is aimed at fulfilling the welfare of the people. In the happiness of the king's subjects lies his happiness. This is what Kautilya said. In the happiness of the king's subjects lies his happiness, in their welfare, his welfare. From this thought springs the idea that the people are necessary participants in creation of systems for governance. Kautilya's Arthashastra talks of a free flow of communication between the king and his subjects. One of the 9 types of royal edicts is response, a reply prepared after the king has read and discussed a communication received. However, a law providing individuals the right to information, access to information held by public bodies did not come in a formal shape till 1766, when Sweden became the first country in the world to adopt such a law. This was followed after nearly 2 centuries by Finland, which adopted such a law in 1951. In 1995, there were only 19 countries with RTI law. However, the increased acceptance of democratic process the world over has led to a much faster rate of adoption of right to information. It is significant to note that even those countries which are not formally democratic in structure have come up with some form of right to information. For a nation which has adopted democracy as a political system, the right to information is even more imperative. The United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights recognizing the right to information as a human right. The right to information is now guaranteed as a fundamental right by the constitution of about 60 countries. The idea behind RTI is that the governments hold information not for themselves but on behalf of the wider public. The right to information has seen a massive increase in acceptance across the globe in the past 20 years. The number of countries which have adopted such a law has increased to nearly 100. Right to information enables greater government accountability, facilitates the citizens' participation and needs, takes it to lend transparency to government functioning. It leads to a fundamental change in relation between the citizens and the government. If there is information, people also will be willing to participate. Because over the years, we politicians, till yesterday I was also a politician, of course now I am not in politics. I am retired from politics but not tired from public life. The habit is that everything is left to government. Sab kaam sarkar karega, am bekar baithe to chalega. This attitude has come into the people because they don't know what is it, what for it is, how far it is going to benefit him. So the right to information enables greater people's participation also in the governance, which is a very healthy sign of democracy. Friends, the attitude of the government agencies also changed since the adoption of the Right to Information Act. Also, a clear attitude of change is visible in public authorities dealing with matters concerning public services and citizens' expectations. We are living in an expectational India. People's expectations are very high. It is also seen that citizens' expectations have changed in the past decade and more from once in 5 years exercise of electoral choice. The citizens now expect to be regularly consulted on matters directly concerning him. The Right to Information Act, adopted by India in 2005, fully recognized this by making it mandatory for central and state governments not only make available certain specific information suo moto to the public, but also to publish all such relevant facts while formulating important policies or announcing decisions which affect public. Administrative authorities are also required to provide reasons for administrative or quasi-judicial decisions to affected persons. When the Chief Information Commissioner, Sri Radhakrishnan Mathurji, came to invite me to inaugurate this convention, he informed me that such conventions have been held right from 2006. The conventions have attracted enthusiastic participants from the state information commissioners, public authorities, students, researchers, civil society, representatives and the media. Today, I see an impressive gathering of persons interested in taking this movement forward. It's a movement. Sachmuch mein ek janandolan hai. Janandolan hona chahiye. Sri Madhur has further informed me that Central Information Commission has been holding its annual conventions with different themes to discuss the issues and arise in implementation of the RTI Act. From the inception, the Commission has discussed diverse topics such as the need for maximum suo moto disclosures, promotion of open government, enforcement of the orders of the Commission and penal clauses in the case of non-compliance of orders, need for strategies specific to rural areas, role of media and civil society in promoting RTI, role of political leadership, RTI and public-private partnership, because nowadays most of the projects are taken up in public-private partnership. The convention have also concentrated on taking stock of implementation of the Act across the country. I just now suggested to him that these conventions should be held in different places across the country rather than holding them in Delhi alone. And I also gave a suggestion to him to study the feasibility and also suggest to the minister concerned, Sri Chandra Singh Ji, that these orders or the applications slowly should move towards the mother tongue of the petitioner. Because according to me, with my little knowledge, 95% of the people do not know English. And we are passing orders in English. And then Hindi. Hindi is of course comparatively known to large sections, but not all people. So the ordinary people who should have the benefit, they should get the benefit of getting the reply in their mother tongue, at least the scheduled languages. I know it requires some infrastructure support. And now with all this transformation that is coming in the IT field, I don't think it's very big task. But attempts, focus should be made in studying it at least to start with. Even I feel even in the arguments in the court also, should be in the language known to the persons. Even to call them litigant, I hesitate. The people who are coming to the court, they don't know what the advocate is saying and what judge is saying. Slowly we must, because I feel log matru bhasha mein apna bhavana vyakt karna unke liye aasan hai, achha bhi hai. People are comfortable in their mother tongue. And I have a theme, I must tell you all frankly, I don't know whether it applies to you all people or not. Everybody who is born, they should first respect their mother, respect the Janma Bhumi native place, respect the mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb, and respect the motherland, the country to which he belongs to. In my own language, I used to say, Kanna Talli, Janma Bhumi, Matru Bhasha, Matru Desam. These four things are very important. Particular reference is about Matru Bhasha, the language that has come from mother's womb. Kitana Sundar Hota Hai. We should inculcate that. But the problem is not with the youngsters. The problem is with our education system, and the Britishers have left our, they left us, but they did not leave our mind. They also taken some part of our mind also. Dekho, even bachchon ka jo pitaji, mataji kya kuchte unse. Arey babu, mummy, daddy, kaho. Mummy, daddy. Amma, antaral se aata hai. Mummy, muh se aata hai. Ab ghar jaake raat ko thoda try karke dekhiye. Ma, Hindi mein. Ammi, Urdu mein. Ammi, mummy. Main kisi bhasha ke virodh nahi hoon. I'm also speaking English, na? We must learn as many languages as possible. I have no problem you learning French, Chinese, even Japanese, even other languages also. But first of all, be fluent, be conversant with your mother tongue. This is my suggestion to the countrymen as such. Wherever I'm going, I'm making this as a mission. Because you will be able to articulate, you will be able to speak better, you will be able to champion the cause because of the language that is you are familiar with. Then other languages and all. I can tell you also, friends, I have been there in the government for some time earlier and now. The Russian Prime Minister, President comes, he speaks in Russian, there will be a translation. The Chinese leader comes, he speaks in Chinese, there is a translation. The French President came, was there, he was speaking in French, and then there is translation. I asked my External Affairs Ministry officials, yeah, in logon ko angrezi malum nahi hai kya? So then aur kuch logon ko malum hai sir, fir un logon ne kaha sir, wo kisi halat mein angrezi mein bolenge nahi, apna matrubhasha mein bolenge. That's the practice world over. But we in India, whether we know it or not, English. Why I'm saying is information. I'm trying to link it with the information. Information must be able to make him to understand what is the information. That's the point I'm trying to make. Slowly, it's now time after 70 years of independence, freedom. We must think in terms of encouraging our own languages. And then learn other languages also. Learning as many languages as possible is a good thing. First, mother tongue. And I always tell mother tongue's importance is mother tongue is like your eyes. Other language is like your chashma. If you know your mother tongue, then chashma will be useful, sir. If your eyes are not functioning, then what is the use of having a chashma? So please focus on that also in the coming days. These conventions are always useful. I'm happy that the chief commissioner, instead of just simply sitting in Delhi, passing on orders from here, is also conversing with the election commissioners of the information commissioners of the states. So that best practices, good examples, various methods. When you have this interaction and this debate goes on or conversation goes on, number of speakers they speak and questions are asked and answers are given, that will enhance the knowledge, collective wisdom of the country and our system. So that's why I'm very happy about this convention. These He has also increased the frequency. That is also required because the new challenges are coming, new problems are coming, new methods are adapted. Some people are misusing this also, I must tell you. There are some people, at the district level, some people complain to me. They file a right to information query. And then they make the concerned person approach him. And later they withdraw. They withdraw. I don't know what is the system here. In my parliament experience, even if you file a question and you disappear for whatever reason it is, question will be answered. In your absence. Yesterday I was going through some disqualification petition. There also I came through a wonderful thing. They said even if the petitioner withdraws petition, still the chair can decide about the maintainability of the petition. So right at this Right to Information Act also, we have to think and also plug the loopholes, how the system is being exploited by some people, vested interest. Some people try to make this. Actually, this is a mission, not about the Information Commission. I'm saying this is a mission. Getting right to information is a mission. But this should not be used for commission. And there should not be any remission. And we should not commit to any omission also. That takes it to perfection and to the satisfaction of the people. This is a very important way I'm telling you, friends. Any system, any method you evolve, some loopholes are being... In this country, there is no dearth of knowledge. there are intelligent people. So please keep that also in mind. And this is a crucial sector where the condition of records and their accessibility is critical to elimination of corruption, middlemen, exploitation. That's the purpose. This sector also contributes to a major portion of civil and criminal litigation in the country. I am sure that the recommendations that had been made in this seminar shall help in addressing critical issues facing this sector. I am also happy to hear from the Chief Information Commissioner that the Commission is working towards bringing down the pendency of cases filed before it within 6 months of registration. An early disposal by the Information Commissioner will help citizens get their grievances redressed quickly, and I would encourage all the commissions to make a concerted, sincere effort towards speeding up a disposal of cases registered with them. Yesterday, just for information, I passed an order on a disqualification within 3 months. And then I gave a strong opinion at the end saying that such petitions should be decided in around 3 months. Because the disqualification petitions that are filed, some of them were pending 4 years. And then order is given after 4 years, 6 months, because 6 months anyhow, again you are going for election. There were instances where people have to go to Supreme Court. So when I passed this order, I thought there will be welcome across the country, of course. People are welcoming it. Some people question, why this alacrity? Why this... Alacrity within the three months the chairman has given order. The justice delayed is denied. You must give information at an appropriate time. And you must also give judgment within time. That's why when I was told that this is going to be done within 6 months, the grievance should be redressed quickly. I would encourage all the commissions to make a concerted, sincere effort towards speeding up disposal of cases registered with them. They must ensure timely and correct information for the citizens. The Central and State Information Commissions are a bridge between public authorities and citizens. I would like them to participate in the public discourse on transparency and RTA-related issues. More importantly, they should give advice to public authorities to improve their process and procedures for decision-making. This would lead to systematic improvements, leading to lesser number of RTA requests being generated. I would suggest that the Commission and the public authorities should take up such an exercise regularly. I remember one young lady who became a municipal chairman. She started a practice. Each ward in her municipality, there used to be signboards. How much is the revenue from that ward? and how much money is being spent for what purpose, and what is the quota, what is the tender, this thing rate, etc., and components and all. It had a terrific impact because people were not willing to pay taxes because they are not confident that the taxes are going to be spent properly. When this girl, lady, brought that change in Taduku, in Andhra Pradesh municipality, wonderful, people started paying taxes more and more. So this information is very important. The other day I also have an example of Hyderabad city where the entire thing is done now, the GPS system, and then they brought everything in computer. The revenue of the city was 735 crores. After this, without enhancing taxes, the revenue has gone up to 1,065 crores. See, if you have the information how much you have built with confirmation, then the revenue also increased. And this, that's why, friends, this it is in this context, I am especially pleased to note that today also the subjects of the convention have been chosen carefully for discussion on Sumoto disclosures, record keeping, emerging issues in implementation of the right to information. I hope that all the participants will find these discussions most productive and contribute to evolution of better transparency and accountability levels. I have great pleasure in inaugurating this convention. These media also has a very important role in the successful functioning of democracy. The parliament has a role, legislature has a role, politicians have a role, political parties have a role, but media also an important role. Because people should get information, who is coming to parliament, who is not coming, who is sleeping in parliament, who is not, who is raising questions, who is not, who is making good contribution, who is making contribution, who is breaking mics. Nowadays, that also become a fashion, na? Assemblies mein kabhi kabhi hum log dekhte hain, assembly mein kehte hain, woh, hey, bahar ao, dekhenge. Bahar wala ko jita hai ke andar bheja. Woh kah rahe, bahar a jao. Mane ye bahar ka maal hai, andar lane, le jane ka layak nahi hai. This is happening to our system. And if the political leadership, if the elected people, if they behave in such a manner, what is the example they are setting to others? We must expose them. And then suppose somebody is making a good speech, made a good contribution, that should be highlighted. But unfortunately, media highlights only side rights, sensationalism. That's unfortunate thing. I have some experience and also I have some authority to say it so. Even at the cost of my media friends, some of them may misunderstand, but I want them to understand properly. The success of democracy, parliamentary democracy, lies in information to the people. People should know what is the character, caliber, capacity and conduct of the gentleman whom you are electing or selecting. What is his contribution? This is the of the government information. The what is the entitlement, right to entitlement, or this thing, act has been passed by Madhya Pradesh legislature. Right to get your entitlement, pension, scholarships, remuneration, or compensation, all this. So see how things are moving. I am telling you, friends, we have seen now, we have earlier seen the statement made by late Rajiv Gandhi. Rajiv Gandhiji, with a good intention, said, if I send 100 rupees from Delhi, by the time it reaches Thiruvananthapuram or Thiruvananthapuram, only 15 paisa is reaching. It was not a political statement. He said it with anguish. We all know, because people do not have the right to that information, they do not know what is the remedy, that is also a problem. That's why now the Prime Minister is talking of DBT, the old government, also present government. DBT means direct benefit transfer. Then he's also talking about JAM, Jana Dana Aadhaar Mobile. Open a bank account and then Aadhaar, and then mobile. Kuch log ne bankon ke bare mein mazak udaya, bank mein khata hone se kya fayda hai, kitna mahatva hai, kitna mahatva hai unko November 8 tarikh ko maalum ho gaya logon ko. Demonetization, war on black money, all is to end corruption. This government or that government, no matter, I don't want to get involved into that. These are the steps that are necessitated because of the failures of the system, na? This is the point I am trying to make. Paisa, kuch log kare, isse fayda kya hai, sir? Pura paisa bank mein pahunch gaya. Mitro, mera kehna ye hai, pura paisa bank mein pahunchna, wahi dakshata, na? That was the aim, to get entire money to bank. Jo paisa bedroom mein, bathroom mein the, pillow ke niche, wo paisa bank mein pahunch gaya. और पैसा पता के साथ पहुंच गया, पिता के साथ पहुंच गया, पति के साथ पहुंच गया, और क्या क्या चाहिए आपको, मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा। अभी उसमें कितना फर्जी है, कितना फर्जी में ना, कितना ब्लैक है, कितना व्हाइट है, वो तो रिजर्व बैंक का काम है। जल्द से जल्द रिजर्व बैंक भी वो काम पूरा करके लोगों को बताना पड़ेगा। द पेन दे हैव टेकन फॉर 50 डेज टू ड्रॉ देयर ओन मनी, नेचुरली यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन, This is the advantage. This much money is official, this much is money is non-official. This many people have come to tax system. They are saying some 56 lakh people have come to the income tax net on account of this. All these details should be made public. They should be given to the people also. Then people will develop more confidence in the system. This is what I am trying to say. But this, there are certain designated authorities, the Reserve Bank has got responsibility. I hope they will do their responsibility. And then, friends, the information has to be prompt. Information has to be timely. Information has to be true. These are the three important things that are required. So I hope in the coming days, all the government departments also, various agencies also, do their duty and see to it that the information, what is required to be given to the ordinary people, or affected people, or deserving people, that should be made available to them, so that to make the commission's job easy. Easy. And there will be, then some people say, sir, commission will become ideal and all. Don't worry. There will be, people will be coming with new ideas also. There is no dearth of ideas among some people. So friends, I'm very happy to be here in today's convention, Information Commissioners Conference across the country. And I convey my best wishes to all of you. And I hope you will satisfy yourself with the responsibilities that is given to you. What is the best satisfaction? Is the satisfaction that your conscience tells you. That is the real satisfaction. Namaskar, Jai Hind.